Before we can actually get in to setting up and configuring the software, we have to get familiar with the user interface, or UI. Following along with the rest of this course, or any tutorial, will be infinitely easier if you already have at least a basic understanding of where to find certain settings and features. The UI doesn't drastically change across updates, so even if you're watching this in the future, this walkthrough should still be relevant. More specific settings and configurations will be covered in relevant lessons throughout this course. This lesson will cover where to find certain UI areas and settings and what they mean to you. The default view of the OBS window houses the stream preview, scenes and sources list, transition controls, audio mixer, start and stop buttons, the studio mode toggle, quick access to the settings menu, and an exit button. As you can expect with any program, at the top of the window or your system title bar on Mac or Linux, if you have the program maximized, houses the menus to access everything. The usual File, Edit, View, Tools, and Help, but also access to your streaming profiles and scene collections, which are absolute necessities if you're using OBS for multiple shows or multiple scenarios, like recording and podcasting. We'll cover those in depth in a later lesson. The bottom of the window contains your recording and streaming timers, frame rate, and CPU usage indicator. By default, the stream preview only has a single window, which shows your active stream view. If you click the studio mode toggle button, it will activate a second window. The window on the right is your active stream preview or program view. It is what your live viewers currently see or what is currently being recorded. The window on the left will show whatever scene you select, also known as the preview view. This is used for adjusting scenes on the fly or preparing a scene before you switch. The menu in between the window allows you to choose the transition options and transition between scenes. The scenes and sources section is for setting up and changing what viewers actually see. Sources are your individual elements, like your camera, game capture, or graphic overlays. Scenes are different groupings of sources for different parts of your stream. For example, having a scene for gameplay footage, featuring your gameplay, an alert box, and a face cam, or a starting soon screen with a countdown timer, or even a scene just for talking to your audience, with just a full screen webcam and a lower third graphic. How much information you get in the audio mixer depends greatly on the individual setup, but for the sake of this course and showing you how it all works, I will assume you're not using any mixing software. Audio levels are typically green, but if you hit 0 decibels or dB, your audio will peak and the meter will turn red. This is not good and can be prevented by keeping your levels set to around negative 10 dB. An often overlooked or undervalued part of the audio mixer is the channel assignment, which allows you to separate your audio sources into multiple audio tracks, which you can then balance in editing or even remove entire audio sources like non-DMCA safe audio. You can find what audio sources are assigned to which tracks by clicking the cog on any one of the meters in the audio meters display and selecting Advanced Audio Properties, or by going to Edit and then selecting Advanced Audio Properties. Again, this will be covered in its own lesson, so don't get too wrapped up in how this is set up. This is just to show you where to find the settings. Let's get into the settings menu. The easiest way to get into the settings menu is to click the settings button in the lower right corner of the window. The general tab houses system-wide UI settings. This includes the options to start recording when you start streaming, the sensitivity of your sources snap, setting up projectors for a monitor, and so on. The stream tab is for choosing the destination of your stream and how you want to connect to that destination. The output tab is where you configure your stream and output settings. This is where you set your codec, audio and video bitrate, and rescale output for your streams and recordings. By default, the simple view of the output tab is selected. But for this course, most of the lessons will use the advanced view, since most of the settings you actually need to configure aren't available in the simple view. The audio tab lets you set up your audio devices like your microphone, monitor output, and so on, as well as push-to-talk hotkeys. The video tab is for configuring your frame rate, resolution, and scaling settings. The hotkeys tab allows you to configure hotkeys to execute just about any action with a press of a key or a few keystrokes. The advanced tab contains higher level settings to configure your stream, like processor priority, color space and range, and stream delays. If you don't like where things are in the main window, you can change it by going into the View tab, then Docs, then clicking Unlock UI. Then you can move any of the docs in the UI wherever you like, simply with a click and a drag. Hopefully, that wasn't too overwhelming. There are a lot of settings in OBS, and the dev team is constantly looking for ways to improve and add to the software. It is extremely customizable, which is the main reason it's my favorite streaming software. By learning the settings thoroughly, you'll be able to adapt when changes and updates happen, and you'll know where to start if or when you have to troubleshoot your streams. In future lessons, in this course, I will be covering settings in more detail, as well as some troubleshooting steps associated with each of them. That's it for this lesson. If this lesson was helpful for you, please do me a favor and hit the like button and tell a friend about this course. I'll see you next time. Stream on.